If there are two things humans seem to love doing, it's separating ourselves and categorizing basically everything into neat little boxes. These two factors came together neatly to create our concept of countries. And countries very often have names that may or may not be a bit too long to type out over and over again, which has created the need for two-letter country codes. However, what exactly are they used for? And how important can these seemingly benign things be to their countries? No, seriously, I promise this will be interesting. This video was sponsored by Hover. So first off, why are these codes so important? Who decides them? How were they created, and what are they used for aside from website domains and the occasional European license plate? Well, these domains are part of something known as ISO 31661 Alpha 2, which is part of ISO 3166, a specification developed by the International Organization for Standardization for the purpose of representing different countries. As might have been implied, there are actually multiple parts to this regulation. ISO 3166-1 defines codes for countries and dependent territories and is itself divided into three parts: Alpha 2 for two-letter codes, Alpha 3 for three-letter codes, and numeric being three-digit codes, allowing people using other writing systems to use these codes without having to switch over to the Latin script. The next two are actually really simple. ISO 3166-2 defines the codes used for subregions like states or provinces, and ISO 3166-3 basically just stores old codes used for countries that don't exist anymore. There's also a handy little table of all 676 possible two-letter combinations, as well as which combinations are currently occupied by countries, former countries, and sufficiently autonomous territories. Which is very handy indeed because, oh look, .zg is still available, and yes, even first-level subdivisions get their own codes, albeit on a different list, like OR for Oregon, BW for Baden-Württemberg, or even NSW for New South Wales. In total, there are well over 5,000 assigned codes, mostly due to all the subdivisions out there, which is even greater than the population of Devon Island, Canada. ISO 3166 was first put forth in 1974, though this version only used the letter codes, with the numeric codes added in 1981, and gradually expanding from there. It was first managed by the Deutsches Institut für Normung, or German Institute for Standardization, though it was later moved to the ISO's offices in Geneva. Being run by the ISO, these codes are recognized worldwide to avoid confusion between the countries wanting to call this place Germany and those wanting to call it something like Alemania, and are also used in machine-readable passports and even in international bank transfers, especially if you've ever had to write out an IBAN, or international bank account number. However, as humans tend to deal with randomly assigned symbolism that means basically nothing at first glance, these codes can have a big impact on the countries that hold them, with some getting insanely lucky in the modern internet-based market. Of course, I absolutely cannot make a video about internet TLDs without of course mentioning Tuvalu. Tuvalu is a tiny island nation in the middle of the Pacific with a population of barely 11,000 people, which itself might not exist in the next few decades due to rising sea levels. Tuvalu doesn't have exactly all that strong of an industrial sector on the world stage, minus of course their ample fishing waters, but in the era of people registering these domains for their websites, Tuvalu got extremely lucky, since their two-letter code is TV, and therefore their internet TLD is .tv, an invaluable domain for websites from twitch.tv to KhAnubis.tv. However, does that make these websites technically Tuvaluan? Many other countries and territories have also gotten some of this luck, with the Federated States of Micronesia having .fm of radio and podcast fame, and the British Indian Ocean Territory having .io of online game fame. So does that make all the websites with domains ending in these codes Tuvaluan or Micronesian or British Indian Ocean Territorian? Well, while these extensions are intended for use by websites based in these territories, in practice, it doesn't always have to be like that. For example, while you generally have to move to Oman to get a .om domain, many other domains are available for public use. And in fact, some, like .tv, are actually registered with the .tv corporation, part of VeriSign, which markets the oh-so-valuable domain in agreement with the Tuvaluan government. There are even more examples than just those three as well, like Djibouti's.dj, Mauritius's.mu, Armenia's.am, Montenegro's.me, and DrKongo's.cd. Using these domain endings for other purposes wholly unrelated to the country in question, or even for wordplay such as hypothetically KhAnubis or Cyrillic.ui or UpAnat.om, or even real examples that actually exist, like goo.gl or u2.be or iton.es, are all things referred to as domain hacks, given that these domains are and can be incredibly useful for these companies, even though my YouTube channel is about as Icelandic as YouTube itself is Belgian. So that's the gist of ISO 3166. Admittedly, while it can definitely have an effect on the world stage, not even getting into what territories are recognized as countries by the ISO, there's not all that much to say about it. I mean, some people 45 years ago sat down and listed all the countries and territories, assigned the two-letter codes that best fit each of them, and that was kind of it. Not so much the controversy or division as things like new international borders or things like that. And when you think about it, that's kind of a good thing. A chaotic world is certainly fun to watch in fiction, but when it comes to people actually wanting to just live their own lives, sometimes international government things being boring can be nice. So after that interesting moral, you might be wondering why I'm suddenly talking about two-letter country codes. Well, first, it's interesting, but also, this week's video was made in collaboration with Hover. Hover is a service where you can reserve whatever domain you want for basically whatever you're working on online. Hover is incredibly easy to use and provides you with all sorts of options. For example, long before they even reached out to me, I reserved the domains KhAnubis.com and KhAnubis.tv, partially to help out Tuvalu as best I can. But you don't have to settle for those regular nerd domains. You can also get .tech, .eu, .online, .enterprises, .camera, .london, .pizza, .productions, or even Punto Football, plus more than 400 other extensions. Hover makes it incredibly easy to connect your domains with your websites, and they have award-winning customer service should you ever get confused. But even if you don't have a website and don't plan on making one, but still want a somewhat professional web presence, for only a little bit extra, you can also connect any domain you've purchased with Hover to a brand new email address that will forward messages to your old and possibly cringily named email. For instance, if you wanted to email me for business purposes a couple years ago, you would have had to go through KhAnubisProductionsOfficial@gmail.com, which became a big pain in the ass, or I guess more accurately pain in the fingers, to write down. But now, if you want to send me an email, you can send it to contact@KhAnubis.tv, which is better in pretty much every way possible, except maybe for the fact that it isn't free, but Hover offers incredibly affordable domains, with no catch whatsoever. And if those prices still aren't cheap enough for you, you can go to the registered domain below to get 10% off your order and help support the channel. Thank you as always for watching. If you like this video, as always, why not show it by liking it, maybe leaving a comment for the sake of audience interaction, share with others who might like this crap, and of course, subscribe if you haven't yet to learn something new every Sunday.